Hi guys, so welcome back to my channel. So today we will do the test number 2 of our series. The first test was on the build quality and the safety features which Honda and Hyundai have come up with their best in segment cars, the Honda City and the Hyundai Verna. And this is test number 2, and this we will conduct on the engine, the drivability, the ride and handling. All these parameters we'll cover in this test. So let's just quickly go, and without wasting any time, we'll just drive the car and I'll let you know my views. Okay, so the Honda City offers you a 1500cc engine. The power figures and everything will appear on your screen. You can see that once. So the engine is quite good, you know, the VTEC motor does its magic, but it does struggle in lower RPMs, like in second gear. It does struggle to give you power for about initial 2 to 3 seconds, but then it picks up pace rapidly. So just one negative in the Honda engine which I have noticed so far: it struggles at lower RPMs, and you know, you will kind of hear that shaft struggling, you know, that sound of that wobbling sound of the shaft struggling at lower RPMs. You can hear those sounds at lower RPMs inside the cabin as well. So the engine does not make that much noise. The cabin is insulated, but still there is quite a little thing going down at the left suspension. There's a wobbling sound or something like that. I'm not sure of that, but there is something which troubles me when I'm driving the Honda City, and that comes from the front left of the car. Otherwise, the cabin NVH levels are decent enough. Like, the engine sound is low and the road sound is also low, but it could have been a bit better. In terms of NVH as well, there's just a little bit of vibration which you feel in the car, and that is coming from the front left only. Otherwise, everything is good. The suspension is very soft, so the ride quality is good in the Honda City because of the softer suspension setup. And the steering is also, like, it's well calibrated. It's not that soft and it's not that hard as well, so I think it has the perfect balance, and it gives you good feedback as well. Like, as soon as you, like, turn it, it will give you proper feedback. So it's well calibrated, I would say. The softer suspension does its job quite well. And the engine picks up pace very rapidly once it crosses about 2000 RPM. Then the amount of power you get above 2000 RPM is extreme. Like, that is the VTEC magic which you get in the Honda City. Braking is good as well. There's no issue with braking. Stability, I have already tested this on the highways, and the car is very stable. So no issues related to stability as well. The car will give you confidence on the highway, on cornering as well, so that's not an issue. And in terms of ownership, like, my experience till now for 2 months, so driving this car is a pleasure. You know, the cabin NVH levels are low, the engine gives you a good amount of power. It just struggles at lower RPMs, but then after that, after crossing about 1500-2000 RPM, then it gives you enormous amount of power. So you enjoy that torque, you enjoy that power, you know. So guys, we are in the Hyundai Verna now. and this brings a new engine to the Verna. Hyundai have brought a new engine. Previously they were offering a 1.6 liter engine, now they have come up with a 1.5 liter engine all across the Verna, like the petrol as well as the diesel. And to be very honest, I am an owner of both these vehicles, but I love driving this Hyundai Verna more because it's more fun to drive. It gives you more power at lower RPMs. Like, as soon as you demand it, you get it. In the Honda City, you have to wait for a couple of seconds or maybe 3 seconds at lower RPMs. It just struggles. The Honda engine just struggles at lower RPMs, but that is not the case with the Verna. Verna will give you power at almost every gear. It won't struggle at lower RPMs as well. And it's certainly like more fun to drive. That's for sure. I love driving the Hyundai Verna more than the Honda City. Coming to the ride and handling, the suspension is a bit stiff in this one as compared to the Honda City. And I somehow favor this stiff suspension more. So it depends individually, like someone may like the softer suspension, some guys may like the stiff suspension. So I am that guy who likes this suspension more because it gives you a lot of confidence when you are driving it over the speed breakers or on the bumps on the road. So it's like it gives you more confidence, these stiff suspension. The ride is not bouncy at all, and there's so much power at lower RPMs. Like, you just love driving the Hyundai Verna in city because as soon as you press the pedal, there's so much of torque which is being developed by the shaft, and this, and hence like there's so much of power produced. And this engine doesn't struggle at all at any gear. It doesn't struggle at all. The steering is quite light as well, again well calibrated. It gives you good feedback, like even the slightest of touches to the steering will give you feedback on the road. Just with just one hand you can, you know, take a U-turn. The steering is so light, and after that U-turn my car was at third gear and it didn't struggle at all. You guys saw that, right? If you want me to rev this engine a bit, here it goes. Braking, awesome. The car won't move an inch left or right when you brake. Stability is damn good, even on cornering as well. Again, I've tested this on the highways as well at about 90-100 kmph. The car didn't struggle at all, and the handling was very good. The stability was awesome. Now see, I've left the steering, I'm putting on the brakes. The car doesn't move at all. It stops as soon as you want it. And when you apply the brakes, it doesn't turn out that the car moves a bit left or a bit right. So that is not the case with the Verna. So the brake force is distributed equally in all four tires. This is so fun to drive, you know. So much of power you get in lower RPMs. In the Honda City, you get the power, but after crossing about 1500 RPM or 2000 RPM, you get huge amount of power. But below 1500 RPM, that car, that engine struggles a bit. So there are so many lovers of the iVTEC motor, but then they do not realize this thing, and they are not ready to, you know, accept this thing. Guys, you have to drive the Verna to accept this fact. I own these both, and I know the exact truth about both the vehicles, either good or bad. I know each and everything in and out of both the vehicles. So don't come up in the comment section saying that you don't know about the IV Tech motor. How can someone say something about the IV Tech motor that it struggles? You have to drive the Verna, you have to drive the Honda City, and then you have to make a decision. Stability, awesome. Ride and handling, awesome. Suspension is a bit stiff, but then it's like it will give you more confidence on bumpy roads. The car won't struggle. The power delivery is awesome, damn awesome. It's clearly the more fun to drive vehicle, guys. So we'll wrap up this video over here, and this test number 2, this is won by the Hyundai Verna. Hyundai Verna is more fun to drive, its engine is more punchy, you get more power at lower RPMs, it doesn't struggle at any RPM at any gear, the ride quality is awesome, the suspension is good, it will give you confidence on bumpy roads as well, it's not bouncy at all, stability is damn awesome, braking is good. So in all terms, the Hyundai Verna is a winner in this test number 2 of our series. So I hope you liked the video, and do comment your views in the comment section, and please like, share and subscribe if you really liked the content. Thank you. Bye bye.